Rajendra Singh from India, in the desert of India, Rajasthan. I am working water conservation and disciplined use of water. When I start this work, that time my area is displaced, no water there. Only children and all people living there. So I start the work with medicine and education with them. Finally, community and old men say, no, medicine and education not our need. Our need is water. So I start with water conservation and catching the clouds and putting the underground aquifers. We control the evaporation laws, and due to the control of the evaporation laws, underground aquifer recharge, water level come up, and my river is flowing. So now our 7 rivers flowing, more than 11,000 water harvesting structure we are created there, but all water harvesting structure creating on the fracture of aquifer, where the water can go in the underground aquifer, or water can go in the subsurface aquifer. Due to this work, the people come back from the city to rural area, and now they are doing agriculture and animal husbandry, and the life with the river is the life of that region. Is also rejuvenate. You know, the water is livelihood, life and dignity. So when the water come, the pupils is very happy and enjoying back to the home. So I can say today more than 8,100 square kilometers, 8,600 square kilometer area we covered to this water conservation. And the 7 river called Arvari, Ruparel, Sarsa, Bagani, Jahajwali, Sabi or Maheshwara. These all 7 river now with water. So when the river with water, so pupils flowing with water. The water come in the eyes of the pupils, in the heart of the pupil, in the body of the pupil, and they really enjoy with water. So due to this work, the rejuvenation of the pupil and rejuvenation of the river or rejuvenation of the area is start. But this all work done by the community. I can't do alone. Only the community can do. Never take help from the government creating the water harvesting structure. Never taken the help of any company or any corporation. The community done that work. So I can say, the community-driven decentralized water management we are doing there, and that make a change. Change of the face of earth and change of the face of pupil, both. So this is my introduction.
Thank you. I just want to ask also a bit deeper into this. You often say that you have transformed the red heat into the green heat. Can you just give a brief explanation to this statement?
You know, when I start the work there, there is really red heat. The clouds not coming there, because if the cloud coming, so without rains going back. Because there is so much heat, barren hills, barren area, no greenery. So I conserve the rains, and that rains creating the moisture in the subsurface and the soil, and that moisture create a greenery. We are doing plantation, we are doing seed sowing everywhere, and the big area in, you know, the long time in, if the you are doing the red heat change in green heat, so taking the time minimum 36 years, so we are doing from long time, so the greenery increase very much. So that greenery, you know, the heat is also in the greenery, but that is the that is not a red heat. The red heat always coming on the cement concrete forest, where you are creating the forest by the cement concrete glasses building, and the barren hills and barren area, naked of the earth. So that is the red heat. When the greenery and the greenery giving a real oxygen to that area, and greenery giving greenery sequestration, doing the carbon dioxide, when the carbon dioxide sequestration in the greenery, so the good atmosphere, the moisture, humidity, and the very good atmosphere there. So that is the good atmosphere and temperature balance give the good rains. The clouds come and giving the very good rains to my area. So now is good rains, balanced rains, not erratic rains coming in my area. So my area is now prosperous, peaceful. You know, the water give the prosperity and peace. So when the water come in the life, so life change with the prosperity and with peace. So this red heat gone and green heat come, and that green heat create a peace in my area. So this is the change.
Thank you. Now this month, September 2015, you participated in the Walking Water pilgrimage here in California, in Owens Valley. Can you describe what you have witnessed there and what you have experienced about the ecological situation here in California?
This water walk in this southern California, and the beginning of the Owens Valley and end of the Owens Lake. So I walk there on earth. That area is now the under the red heat, the total barren land, and you know, the desert. That area is not before desert, this is the new desert. Because when I walk there, so I see some old, dry, dead water bodies there. That water body is showing the some indigenous people living before. And they, water body is created by the indigenous people there. And that indigenous people living with greenery and with water there. But now, no water there, no greenery there, no indigenous people there. Now is the completely desert area. So this desert on the name of the treatment of the dust or desert, what they're doing in the government, that is very sad for you. The billions and billions dollars is spending, the controlling the dust and the name of the cleaning the air. You know, the roads and dams and bunds and the blocks they are creating. The dust never controlled by the roads or by the bunds. They never controlled by the greenery. The dust controlled by the greenery, not by the roads. So they are not creating the greenery. They are creating the roads within the lake. So I seen they are controlling dust by the water trucks moving there. And that water trucks can't control the dust. They are creating the dust. So there I seen on the name of the development what is going on. That is the real displacement of the indigenous wisdom and the displacement of the greenery. And that work creating a destruction. You know, the creating the destruction. And finally, this destruction reaching on the disaster, like drought, like flood. The droughts and flood is always disaster of the man-made disaster. So, reaching the man-made disaster. So, I am really very much sad experience in the Ons Valley or Ons Lake. The government never discussed within the community. The indigenous community living in Big Pine, Long Pine, Independent, and I think now I can suggest to my government of USA, they discuss with community. You know, the community can make a environment and the community can help to the government. If the community, water and government make a bridge. The community and government make a bridge and addressing the issue of water, they can do. You know, in my area, community done. Here is also community is ready. But need today, the government of California discuss with the community. And community give the solution. You know, the climate change and global warming is a global problem. But the solution is always local. The local solution give the success. The global taking the time very much and just creating a, on the name of the development, creating the displacement, destruction and disaster. So if we can start with the local community, so we can give and we can explore the solution.
For the ecological situation, the water situation here in California, you said in your speeches in the last days that it is possible to solve it. It is not over.
Yes.
Can you give a few basic advices what the people here in California need to change in order to overcome the water crisis and have a prosperous future?
Yes. Southern California, this problem is not over. If the government of California is really serious and the government of Los Angeles. I listened to the mayor yesterday. He speaks very well. He speaks very radical speech for the ecological and environmental. But I don't understand why he is not doing for the Los Angeles solution for water. I feel in the Ons Valley is a real source for the Los Angeles, the water source for the Los Angeles. And he promised in his speech, yes, now he is focused on the water harvesting and water conservation in Los Angeles. But if this government, what he speak front of me, if he is doing. So, in the speech of the mayor is really very good, and I can suggest what he is doing, what he say, and I can remembering again to him. We need water harvesting in the urban area. They can start with rooftop harvesting and they can create the new water bodies. You know how much water going on the ocean. So if they can harvest that water, that is the sweet water, why they are spending the money of the desalination plant or desalination plants? No need of the desalination of the ocean water. You know how much pollution creating the desalination? And how much big disaster the desalination of the water? No need of the desalination. The need is they harvest, they conserve, and they make some discipline of the uses of water. How much water misusing in the Los Angeles? So they can watch that. So if we are really serious about the water, so one hand conservation and harvesting, other hand discipline uses of water. So if we can join the conservation and discipline, so we can resolve the problem of the California or of the Los Angeles.
Last question I want to ask is about an initiative you've started recently, the World Water Walks for Peace. Can you explain what it is and why you are starting this initiative?
This World Water Walk for Peace is a really accept the challenge of the 21st century. You know what is the challenge today? Today, the exploitation of water, exploitation of the underground aquifers. Our all universities, all technical institute teaching us the technology of the extraction and exploitation of water. So we are really expert today and on the exploitation of water technologies. So we are going more than 1,000 meter deep and we are taking the water from the underground aquifer. So now our deposits of the water, our banks of the water is empty. And we encroaching the land of water harvesting structures, water bodies, lakes and rivers. Now the increase the rate of the land, so the real estate and the government both, they are encroaching the common property of the water. So the encroachment of the common property water bodies, lakes and rivers. This is a real serious threat for future. And you know, the pollution. So I can say exploitation, encroachment and pollution is a big threat of this century. And these threats creating a tension, conflict. These tension and conflict changing into war. So, I know in this world, the 99%, or I can say, the 95% pupil is not in the favor of the war. Only 1% pupil is doing encroachment, pollution and over-extraction, and the only 1% they are doing, and the 4% pupil is helping them. They are the opportunist force. They are the helping them. So only the 5% pupil who is doing encroachment, pollution and exploitation of the water resource. So they are the creating the situation for war. The rest 94% pupil, they are really very good, but they are not capable stopping or controlling this negative war. But they are really in the favor of peace, fear of peace. And the only 0.7% pupil is who is really ready stopping the war and changing into peace. These all 99.7% pupil is in one place. Negative force, opportunist force, yes, good, but unable. Very good pupil and motivator, they are living. And the 0.7%, 0.3% is pupil like this. These pupils know to each other, all of them. If we can join these 0.003% and 0.007%, we can join like this, so we can change war into peace. We are capable. 1% pupil is really capable, because the 1% pupil is negative and 1% pupil is positive and effective. So when these people join, so 94% pupil join them. So the force is here. So these force, and after that the opportunist coming in this, because that, and this scenario. But you know, today what is going on? Today this scenario has changed like this. This is this negative force join with them. They are trying negative force join with them like this. When the negative force join with them, so the opportunist force come like this, and this is the situation creating now today. This is the negative scenario today. So we can change this scenario like this. We can make the strong communities, and the strong community can change the war into peace. So we are decide now, we are going the world over every country and every continent, and we can touch with these people and with these people, and we can make a system like this. And we awake this and this. And awareness and atmosphere building, creating like this. So now we are trying to connecting with good pupil, and we are starting the World Water Walk for Peace. The first year we are connecting them. Second year we are going there everywhere where the good pupil living, and they are really favor of the equity. Water is not a commodity, water is a common life. So who believe that we are going there? And 2017 we join each other and meeting at Geneva, and after that we make a next plan for there. So now World Water Walk for Peace is going on, where the good pupil is working on that line. So now we are going there, and when after that the all pupil join and creating the atmosphere for the war change into peace.